Next time you seen him was in the tunnel?
Yeah. The first time that we... people
got you held him down.
Right. People got to understand,
take
like...
Take your shot, brother? I'm not sure. Mm-hmm. All right, I'm not sure. You got to finish your shit over here. This is not called half a shot.
Damn,
shot.
I see what he on now. Nah, don't worry. I'm going to hit fifth gear because I see you already. You like booming and wrestling.
We happy to have you. We happy to have you.
Boom. So... we was in the tunnel, and people got to understand the umbrella I was under, to put it that way.
Right.
But I know, niggas know what I'm talking about, so it was certain folk connected to certain folk.
Right.
And we was all at the tunnel.
Right.
So I remember, shout out DJ, and shout out Stretch, and Bags, rest in peace, Bags.
You Money Bags?
Yeah.
Rest in peace, you Money Bags.
Shout out Bags. Shout out, these are the people that was there.
Okay.
So, you know, he's in the tunnel, and mind you, I remember going up to him, but I'll be honest, I wasn't a fan of his music. Right. I wasn't.
Almost say you didn't like him. Like,
right, but you gotta put it in context of which Tupac. The first one is the Holler If You Hear Me Tupac, I'm assuming.
Right, so all and of that I wasn't into. So Brenda Got a Baby was like the only record that I was like, yo, that nigga from the West Coast who sings that Brenda shit, that shit is.
But that's the first one you mean, the Freaknik Tupac.
Right, and then that's Freaknik Tupac.
Fast forward, and how many.
Now I'm meeting.
Not Death Row Tupac yet, is it?
No, not
yet. You're on the cusp of becoming Death Row Pop.
Okay, all right.
I want to see Me Against the World.
If he was on the cusp, he definitely wasn't Death Row
Tupac.
Right,
so it was Me Against the World.
Right.
So all the OG niggas is discussing what they discuss. We're not paying no attention to that. It's me, Web, Pac, my brother, and we the ones that decide to break away from that main ball. You know how it was, nigga. You came in, and it was the first ball here, and the Queens niggas would be on this side. The BK niggas would be on their side against the wall. Then you walk further into the tunnel. So they was there talking whatever they was talking about, but the nigga Pac wanted to walk around. Mm. So me, my brother, and Rev, we all broke off and started walking.
And you're not Mike Geronimo yet, or you Mike Geronimo?
No,
shit is real?
Okay,
okay.
So,
so it's 96, 95, 95.
So whenever the year the tunnel was like all roads lead here. That was
like 10 years though. Thank so, but in that bro. Area, I can what you said. Yeah.
So we start walking towards like that where you know where you break off in the center. There's the dance floor, but on the right there was like a hallway with like little mirrors, and you could like put your weed there, roll it, whatever, and that led to the backstage. If you walk this whole way. So first we start walking and he pulls the weed out and he's the point. He's on point.
Pop.
Right. He's in front of everybody.
But he's not with y'all.
Yeah.
Oh, he's with y'all.
Yeah.
With y'all.
He was like, yo, I want to walk around. So I told BJ and I was like, yo, we'll walk around because we wanted to smoke. We's the young niggas that smoke weed all day.
So you telling me BJ and Irv guy, this is true, they actually met Pac. They knew. Okay.
Yeah. I knew Pac because of BJ.
Okay. Wow.
And because of Irv.
Wow.
And Irv kind of, it's funny because Irv always would talk to me about Pop.
Yeah, doing a record with him?
And doing a record with him. And I was in heavy opposition to it because I was like, I'm not working with anyone I fucked with on Natural. That's not just for the sake of fucking with you to make a song. Right. These are my friends. This is my family. It feels so good now, bro, to look back at that album and be like, yo, this is my family, bro.
Which you album, Natural? Me?
Yeah. Even Vendetta. Even Vendetta, the second one.
Okay, okay.
Even working with Coffin and Hitman and.
Oh, we're going to get to that.
So.
We're going to take another Ciroc shot when we get to that.
Oh, all nigga. Right, cool. I'm behind you. I see your blankets. It's all good. So we walk in and a nigga bumped this nigga. The nigga had a yellow.
As he was rolling the
wheel. As he's rolling.
Right.
Now, at that point, I couldn't rightfully say it's malicious or it had an intent to it. All you could say was somebody's walking forward, you walking this way, boom, you collide the weeds on the floor. So the nigga bumped him, but I didn't see the bump.
Okay.
I just seen his face.
Right?
So he does this shit. So I just like, on some quick shit, I was like, yo, don't tread. We all right. Like, yo, just keep going. We all right. Like, we want to go this way, bro. Don't worry about it. Whatever. So he takes a couple steps further, and another nigga bumps him. But now we're on that hallway.
And you see this guy.
And I seen this one. And I swear on God, bro, on my kids, I never forget the look on his face, because it was the first time that I said to myself, it must be a nightmare for somebody that have to consistently be persecuted.
You talking about Tupac?
About Pac, because he had this look on his face that was like, yo, I'm so tired of this shit. And it didn't look like...
And Pac had no security? Y'all was the security.
We was the security. Wow. But when I seen... I'm not going to say... but the OGs we was with.
Right.
The affiliation. You feel me?
Right. They were the security, but you was holding it down.
But I'm holding it down. You my man's man. I'm not going to let...
Right.
We all here.
We going to walk around.
By default, nigga.
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
So I saw this whole interaction. And I never forget his face. And he just looked drained, bro. He just looked not like, I can't do this and I won't win. He just looked like, why do I have to keep doing this? And when I seen it, I was infuriated.
For him.
Like, point for him.
Right.
And at that, and it was so strange, because anything that I may have felt prior to that evaporated. And as soon as I saw it, I immediately grabbed him by his shoulder. I said, yo, get behind me. And my brother, shout out my brother Kev, my brother was like, yo, we got, he was like, get between me and Mike.
That's Pac telling us he's with us right now. You heard that? You heard me? Go ahead.
So, you don't understand, I love that nigga, my nigga. More now, more than ever, you don't understand. I'm going to get to another story.
Right.
So I just tell him, I'm like, yo, get behind me. Just get behind me.
So
now, so now I'm here, Pac's behind me, my brother's behind him, Oomph is behind my brother. Mm. And we keep walking to where we gonna go. I see a nigga fitting and come up again.
Are these related events though, or just people
the same night?
The same night.
The people this that are bumping them, are they, do they, is they
yeah, together? I didn't know whether they all knew each other, or whether they were just taking advantage of a moment.
Right, right.
But when I saw
like and witnessed
this, right. When I saw the second bar, I was like, nigga, all bets is off.
Right.
So now there's a third nigga, light skinned nigga, never forget. Light skinned nigga, taller than me, like curly ass hair, walking towards me. And I could just see the shit in his face. I could smell it.
He on some bullshit.
He on some bullshit.
New York bullshit.
Nigga, I had a pen in my pocket, bro.
Right.
Say, hold
I clutched the ballpoint pen in my pocket, I swear. That's where I'm at. I grabbed the pen in my pocket, and before the nigga gets to us, I stick my arm out. I was like, I'm going to tell you right now, the next nigga that bumps this nigga, I'm fucking everyone up in this club. Period. And I know what you don't. I'll get out. You won't. I'm going to be okay. In more ways than one. You gonna learn a valuable lesson.
The tunnel is serious.
And the nigga stopped and the nigga said the most ignorant shit I've heard. The nigga was like, come on, Mike, them West Coast niggas. I said, what the fuck has this nigga ever done to you?
Right.
You don't even know this nigga.
Wow.
What has this man ever done to you? The next nigga that bumps this nigga, I will fuck this entire club up now. And that was it.
Fire. Fire.